which I believe is not uncommon, has to do with musical hallucinations. I wrote about these in my Man Who Mistook His Wife for a Hat book, and this sort of opened the floodgates. Many people wrote to a columnist called Dear Abby, saying, yes, they too had musical hallucinations. They said it was, they never mentioned it to their husband and wife. They were afraid it might connote something awful. They'd been to their doctor, who had ignored them. And then Dear Abby asked me if I would comment on these letters. And rightly or wrongly, I did so. And since this time, I've had a Niagara of letters. I would think close to 1,000. So I've written odds and ends about music over the years, but basically since 1990 or so, neuroscience for the first time has interested itself in music.